Good morning, everyone. How are you all? Fine. Very good. In the last lecture, I had discussed about the domestic territory of a country, in which you might have learned what are included in the domestic territory and what are not. The part which are included in domestic territory, they generate income through the process of economic activities which are carried out by the normal residents of that country. Although a part of domestic income is also generated by non-residents, however, it is mainly generated by the normal residents. How we shall discuss this difference later on in the coming topics. Let us begin with the same definition which I am explaining for the last 2 or 3 days. What is national income? National income is the aggregate of money values of all final goods and services produced within the domestic territory of a country by its normal residents. Till the domestic territory, we have discussed much. What are called final goods, we have discussed. What is called domestic territory, we have discussed. And today, we shall discuss about the normal residents who undertake economic activities to generate income. Okay? The question arises, who are called normal residents? Here, it is important to understand that normal residents do not refer, yes, normal residents refer to not only the men but to institutions also, means the companies, business firms, NGOs, clubs and organizations like them will also be treated as the normal residents in proceedings of national income accounting. Thus, from this point of view, the normal residents of a country can be defined as those persons and institutions who normally reside in a country and whose center of economic interest lies in the same country. Here, to identify the normal resident, it is important to understand the term economic interest. A person or an institution will be the normal residents of which country? It depends on where his, yes, the center of economic interest lies in which country, means within the domestic territory of which country that person or institution is engaged in the economic activities for more than 1 year. It means a person may be residing in a country, however, he or she may not be the normal resident of that country. And a person may not be residing in the same country, however, he or she may be the normal resident of that country. Okay? Not of that where he or she is living. In what way? The citizenship is not a criteria to decide the normal resident. The criteria is the center of economic interest. You are the normal resident of which country? It is decided by this factor that within the domestic territory of which country you are having your economic interest, you are engaged in the economic activities, or from where you are getting your income. Although the normal residents may earn some income from abroad also, but basically they are engaged in economic activities within the domestic territory of a country. Once again, normal residents are those persons and institutions who normally reside in a country, maybe some circumstances in which they may not reside in the same country, how we will discuss after it. And the center of economic interest lies in that country. Okay. Now, some examples who can be treated as the normal residents of a country. You must go through different examples from your textbook also. Why? Because example-based questions are asked in the board examination. In normal residents, we may include the common citizens who are normally residing in the country and operating their economic activities within the domestic territory of the same country. Number two, the persons, as for example Indians, who are working in the embassies of India located abroad. Although they are not residing here, but they will be treated as normal residents of our country. The Indians, the people, for example, Indians who are working in the ships, aircrafts, oil and natural gas rigs, floating platforms running and floating abroad. They are not residing in India, but you know, they are the normal residents of India, although they are residing outside the India, because their center of economic interest is lying in India. If we apply the criteria of citizenship, then also we may find that if an Indian goes abroad and stays there for more than 1 year, then by remaining citizen of India, he will be treated as the normal resident of that country where residing. Thus, a foreigner may also be the normal resident of another country if he or she stays there for more than 1 year. But there are exceptions to this rule. If a foreigner comes in a country for medical treatment, for playing matches, for traveling, for tourism, or for working on contractual basis, or for some other purposes for less than 1 year, then they will be treated as non-residents of the country where they have come. In fact, then they will be treated as normal residents of that country to which they belong. Okay? So the criteria of citizenship is only one criteria. The most important criteria is the center of economic interest. There are some important other things also to be noted in our mind, such as there happen to be the offices of international organizations in different countries, And these offices of international organizations like UNO, WHO, UNICEF, UNESCO do not belong to a particular country. Then the people working in the offices of these organizations will be treated as the normal residents of which country? The provision is that they will be treated as the normal residents of their respective countries. Such as, if an Indian and an American both are working in the office of WHO who in India, located in India. In this circumstance, a controversy may arise if they will be treated as the normal residents of which country. The concept says that the American will be treated as the normal resident of America and Indian will be considered as the normal resident of India. Similarly, if the foreigners work in embassies of other countries, then also they are treated as the normal residents of their respective countries, of their own countries. Okay, the diplomats, high officials, etc., treated as non-residents. Okay, simply those persons who do not have their center of economic interest in our country, those institutions also, they are the non-residents. So I think it is clear who are the non-residents and who are the normal residents. While we estimate national income, first we estimate domestic income. And in domestic income, we include the incomes earned by non-residents as well as normal residents, but largely by normal residents. How we shall discuss incoming topics, okay? Once again, come to the definition of national income. What is this? The aggregate of money value of all final goods and services produced within the domestic territory of a country by its normal residents. The concept of normal residents, I have tried my level best to make it clear. Despite if you have some confusions or some queries to ask, you can contact me. Thank you very much.